Christ alone, my hope is found, and He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all.
Father, thank You for Your love. Thank You for the fact that You loved us so much that You sent Your Son to die for us, that nothing that we could do could replace Your love for each and every one of us. Thank You for each one who's in the service this morning. Dankie vir elkeen wat hier is vanoggend. Seën hulle asseblief in die teenwoordigheid. Mag hulle met die God wat hulle nodig het om te ontmoet, ontmoet vanoggend. May we meet the God that we need to meet with this morning. Father, be the God we need You to be. Help us to make sure that our picture of You in our heart is the true picture, die ware prentjie van God is, wat in ons harte is. Dis 'n God van liefde, dis 'n God van seën, dis 'n God wat vir ons is, nie wat teen ons is nie. Help ons om dit te besef vanoggend en dit te beleef in hierdie diens. Heilige Gees, kom praat met elke siel. Holy Spirit, come and speak to each heart this morning. And we pray, Lord, yes, that where Your word is waar U woord gepreek is in hierdie vallei, hierdie Sondagoggend, mag die autoriteit en die krag van die Heilige Gees saam met dit gaan. En mag dit harte tref en lewens verander. We pray, Lord, for the difference that Jesus makes in each soul, each heart, each life. And Father, we thank You that we can bring those to You who are hurting, those who are physically in need of a touch, those who financially are battling, emotionally stressed out, spiritually in need to grow. Father, we bring them to You, we lay them before You, and we ask that Your grace will touch their lives, that U genade hulle sal raak, hulle die krag sal gee om elke môre in en uit U te leef, tot eer van U naam. Seën ons asseblief in Jesus naam. Amen. If you have your Bibles, then turn with me to Ephesians chapter 4. Ephesians hoofstuk 4. And we're going to look from verse 17. Vanaf vers 17 van Ephesians 4. And we're in a sermon series entitled Faith Trumps Life. Now, I don't know, all you gamblers, all of you who've played, you know, gambled with poker and cards and stuff, there's a higher card that trumps all other cards. So you put down three of a kind and some fool puts down two pairs of a higher kind or three of a higher kind, and that higher card trumps your card. And obviously the ace is the highest card, so ace trumps everything. Now in life, faith trumps everything. Wat is jou probleem? Geloof is die antwoord. En laasweek het ons mekaar gevra, weet jy wat jy weet? Do you know what you know? Do you know what you know? Because it's so important. Faith is not a leap into darkness. It's nie 'n blindelingse tree wat 'n mens gee. Jy staan op die woord van God. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So the more of the word of God you know, the greater your faith can be. And so it's not a blind leap. It's not a closed eyes, just step and hope. It's a step onto what you know that you know about God. And this morning, I want to focus in on that again out of Ephesians chapter 5 and tell you that Jesus Christ is the truth. Jesus Christus is die waarheid. But I want to share it in a way that, again, three points. You were, you can, you are. Jy was, jy mag, jy sal wees. Jy is. And I want to show it to you. And I hope I get to the third point. I hope I get to the third point because that's the good news. Okay, but let's start. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 17. So this I say and affirm together with the Lord. Now, Paul is quite interesting here. In some of his other letters, he says, I say to you, and then he says, but Jesus says. But Jesus said this, but I say to you. And here he says, I say to you, and I affirm with Jesus. Now, when Paul says, I say to you, or I affirm together with Jesus, who is it that's saying, I say to you? Dis 'n apostel van die Here onder die inspirasie van die Heilige Gees. So is nie sy opinie nie. It's not his opinion. He's saying, as an apostle, inspired by the Holy Spirit, I say to you this truth. So he's not being arrogant. He's just realizing what his authority and what his point is. And I said to you last week, when you know that you know that you know that you're right, you battle to give up the argument. Is nie lekker om in te gooi, as jy weet jy is reg, en allemaal om jou is dom, en wil nie verstaan nie, dan wil jy ons aanhou stry, jy wil sê maar, ja, ek hoor jou, maar, this is the truth, what don't you get? Paul's saying here, hey, I know this, and I affirm it to you with Jesus, together with the Lord. Listen to what he says, that you no longer walk just as the Gentiles also walk in the futility of their mind, being darkened in their understanding, excluded from the life of God because of the ignorance that is in them, because of the hardness of their heart, and they, having become callous, having given themselves over to sensuality for the practice of every kind of impurity with greediness. Oh, you were, I was, alive in the futility of my mind. I lacked understanding. I lacked knowledge about life. I thought I knew life. I thought I could do life. I thought it was all about me. It was what I felt. It's what for my lekker gevoel het, dis mos die rede om dit te doen. Hoekom doen jy dit? Want het voel reg. Okay? And we lived in ignorance of life, and we lived in the full understanding of fulfilling the flesh, of meeting the needs, the desires, the wants of the flesh, and giving myself over to with greediness. Het jy al agtergekom? Sonde is nooit versadig nie. Dit wat jy vandag gesondig het, moet jy bietjie ekstra aansit môre, anderstens is dit net nie dieselfde nie. Gister se sonde, nee, jy moet bietjie meer ekstrem gaan vandag om daai selfe kick te kry. That's why drugs and let's go into any of the slave things that slave us, that enslave us. All of those things, start with just a little bit. Let's just try a little bit. And then a little bit becomes a little bit more, until it takes over. And with greediness, we give over to every kind of pleasure. That's where we were. That's what we lived. That's what we came out of. Now listen to me this morning. That's just the introduction of where we were and where many people are. So if you meet people, whether they call themselves Christians or not, sal hulle self gelowiges verklaar of nie, kinders van die Here of nie. As jy die vrug in hulle lewe sien, dan moet jy hulle bevraagteken. You must ask a question. Why is it always about you? Why is it always about what's good for you? Why does every conversation, why does everything that we do always go around what is good for you? Do you lack understanding? And then he says, I go back to verse 17, that you no longer walk just as the Gentiles also walk in the futility of their mind. Hold on to that thought. Hold on to that thought, because I'm going to show you where it comes from and how we can become what Jesus died to make us. How we can become what Jesus died to make us. Remember our main pillars? Christian, holiness, missional. We save the lost. We save those who are in the futility of their mind. We shape those who are saved. Ons vorm daai wat gered is met die Heilige Gees van God, nie ons nie. Gelukkig. Dink net as ek aan julle moes werk. Ek sê gister vir iemand, julle het my gevra om julle te trou. Dis reg, is goed, dis lekker. Ons gaan party, dit gaan mooi wees. Maar onthou, ek is deel van jou huwelik daarna. As julle aanjag gaan kom, sit ek op julle. You've asked me to be a witness, I will hold you to your vow in the years that come. You want me to be part of your marriage? You must rather get another dominie. Get someone that's a bit lighter in your broek. Ek's a bit swaar. Okay. As ek op jou sit, sal jy weet. Okay. But, verse 20. Look at verse 20. I love the buts in the Bible. I love the buts in the Bible. You were caught up in the futility of your mind. You lacked understanding. You gave yourself over to the greediness of the flesh. But you did not learn Christ in this way. Jy het nie Christus so geleer nie. And you have been taught in Him. You did not learn Jesus this way. And you've been taught in Him. Why must I go to church, Pastor? Why must I attend a Bible study? Because you need to get into the Word of God and you need to get into it with someone who can lead you. Jy weet die kring van die sporters. Jy moet baie versigtig wees dat jy by wie jy sit. As jy Bybelstudie doen en die een ou is, let me put it nicely, not as clever as you. Okay, and you guys decide you now want to work out what the truth is. Be careful. Allow the Holy Spirit to lead you into truth. Don't just sit and take in what anyone says. Test the Spirit. Test what's being said. Beproef daai wat vir jou geleer word. Last week I said, too many people stand in pulpits, too many people want to preach a politically correct gospel. Hulle wil mense streel met hulle vorm van die waarheid, in plaas van om die waarheid te verkondig. And we must speak the truth in love, but without apology. What does it mean to speak the truth in love? I respect the person in front of me, so I handle them with respect, but I tell them the truth. Christianity is not just we all love each other. Okay? If unfortunately in many churches, we all nice each other. Nice is a four-letter swear word. Because nice says, I tell you what I think you want to hear. I don't want to offend you. I don't want to confront you. I don't want to get in your nose. I don't want to pick you. Okay? Nee-syndroom. Hier gee ons nie om nie. Ons het nee-syndroom. We pick on one another. Yeah. Awesome. I love you enough to tell you the truth. If I don't love you enough, I'll be nice to you. Okay. But you did not learn Christ in this way. If indeed you have heard Him and have been taught in Him, just as truth is in Jesus. Do you know what you know? Ken jy die waarheid? Ken jy Jesus? Too many people claim to be Christians because they're encouraged to say a prayer of salvation. They're encouraged to sign a tract that they gave their heart to the Lord. They're encouraged to visit a church once a week. They're encouraged to pay a percentage of their money to a church. That's not Christianity. That's not Jesus. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is die waarheid. Jesus is die enigste antwoord vir die lewe. You see, a Christ, I'm so glad. You know what? These guys had problems. Because the Jewish people who had hold of the church, because Jesus was a Jew, and they just thought, well, he comes out of Judaism, so you know what? It's Jesus plus circumcision and no more pork. Just there, I resign and I walk out. Vat vark van my weg. Ek sal ander mens, ek sal vark word. And people always want to add on something because it comes out of a me mentality. We cannot accept that it's just Jesus. Ja, dis, luister, die hartseer van die bestaan van kerke, is het gaan nou oor, dis Jesus plus ons vorm van godsdienst. Dis Jesus plus ons is reg, hulle is verkeerd. Nee, dis Jesus plus die koninkryk van God. En elke kerk het 'n bestaansreg as hulle die woord verkondig en toelaat dat die Heilige Gees in hulle werk. Where the word of God and the spirit of God leads us into all truth and Jesus Christ is the only means of salvation. Then you're part of the kingdom of God. And yeah, if we have different rituals, different ways of living out that faith, that's okay. Dankie tog. Ek ondersteun die haie. Dit's nodig om bietjie verskeidenheid in die kerk te hê. Just imagine we were all blue bulls. How boring would life be? Okay? How pathetic life would be. But anyway, that's just my opinion. That's not under the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. The point I want to make is, each one of us gives expression to our love, to our passion in a different way. Some of us are more conservative. Some of us are more demonstrative. But that's okay. Let's not fight over the expression of our love for Jesus. Because at the end of the day, if you know Jesus and you've been taught Jesus and Jesus is your truth, then Jesus is the divider. Nothing else. Nothing else. Niks anders. Bring divisie. As ons in Jesus is, en die kerk is in Jesus, en die mense is in Jesus, Paulus het hoeveel keer gesê, ek gee nie om. Terwyl ek hier in die tronk sit, en hulle preek, hulle gebruik my tronkskap, my gevangeniskap, om die evangelie op hulle manier te verkondig. Ek het nie 'n saak nie, ten minste word die evangelie verkondig. It's not about me. It's not about my method. It's not about my style. It's about Jesus being announced as the answer. And guys, we lose that. We miss that so much. We get so caught up in little things. What's it going to matter? The divider is Jesus. He's the truth. John 14 verse 6. Ek is die weg, ek is die waarheid, ek is die lewe. Niemand kom by die Vader uit behalwe deur my. I'm the way, the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me, says Jesus. So, you were, but you can because of Jesus. You can what? So glad you asked. Hello? So glad you asked. Look at verse 22. That in reference to your former life, you lay aside the old self, which has been corrupted in accordance with the lusts of deceit, and that you be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and put on the new self, which in the likeness of God has been created in righteousness and holiness of the truth. Whose truth? Wie is waarheid? Jesus Christus. Wil jy regverdig? Wil jy heilig wees? Dan moet jy in die waarheid wees. Wat is die waarheid? Die waarheid is, Jesus het gesterf. Sodat die ou self kon uitgetrek gewees het. Listen, your clothing determines you, defines you. This guy that I'm marrying, he's a friend, and he says to me, thank you for not asking anything to marry us. I said, no. There is a price. There is a price. I'm not asking you any money, but once you're married and you go into the reception, you're wearing a Sharks shirt. Och, en hy's 'n blowbill, hoor. Ek dink hy het nie eers enige iets swart in sy huis nie. Nie eens swart skoene nie. Maar ek sê vir hom, nee, jou betaling. Your clothing defines you. Defines your life. Just think about it. If you see somebody walk into church and they're scruffy and they're dirty and there's holes in their clothes, I'm not talking about a farmer who's been working hard, eh? I'm talking about someone who's, you know, immediately you put a label on that person. You think something of that person. If you come in like the bunch of you are dressed today, then it's fine. But imagine if someone came in here in a suit and tie, three-piece suit with a waistcoat and what are you immediately going to ask them? Where are you going? Waar gaan jy? Jy kom nie so kerk toe nie. Wat's fout met jou? Ons is nie so hierso nie. Klere definieer. Your clothing, your outlook defines you. In Jesus Christ. Listen to me. Here we not. We're in partnership. Salvation is from God. Salvation is from God. It starts with God. It continues in God and it ends in God. Nothing of you can save you. Nothing of me can save me. But the amazing thing is, God says to us, I limit my ability. I limit my power. Ek beperk my almagtigheid om julle eie wil, vrye keuse te gee. Ek wil hê julle moet in samewerking met my jou redding uitwerk met vrees en bewering. That's what's so amazing. I cannot, how many times have I told you? What is the greatest show, sign, display, example of God's love for mankind? Come on, iemand wat nog nie dit gehoor het, gaan die kruis sê, nê? You're going to say the cross because you're in church and it must be the cross. It has to be the cross. Nuh-uh. It's not the cross. It's free will. Free will is God's greatest demonstration of love for you. Because He knew. In sy alwetendheid het hy geweet die effek van sonde op die hart van die mens. Hy het geweet dood, siekte, lyding, swaar kry, pyn, ellende, alles gaan as gevolg van sonde. God het dit nie beplan nie. As jy na die tuin van Eden kyk, was alles goed. Everything was very good. But He gave mankind free will, knowing that it would cost Him His Son to die a cruel death. It pleased the Lord. It's in Scripture. It pleased the Lord to punish Him because of the result of that death on the cross was your and my restoration. And that's the good news. It's Jesus. You and I, without Jesus, can I remind you? You walk in the futility of your mind. Your best thinking is rubbish. You're darkened in your understanding. You're excluded from the life of God because of the ignorance that you have in you, because of the hardness of your heart. When truth, when goodness, when blessing, when life is offered to you, jou hart is so verhard. Jy is so reg in jou eie denke, in jou eie wil, in jou eie lewe, dat jy sê nee vir dit wat vir jou geoffer is. That's the truth. but Jesus. But Jesus. And then he says, Jesus is the truth. Now here's the partnership. Hier is die vennootskap. Lay off the old. Trek on die nuwe. Lay off the old. Physically, there's a command. You have to. How do I lay off the sin? How do I lay off sin? I can't. Jesus Christ enables me. I just have to agree with him. Ek moet net saam met hom stem dat dit. Listen, if someone says to me, Sean, take off that tie, man. It's grobless dull. None of us have got a tie. What do you want to wear a tie for? Kom neem hierdie das van my af. Kom. Trek hierdie das van my af. Yeah. Jy gaan nie. Kom, probeer. Kom, kom. Nee. Kevin, nee. Ah, oké, okay, dat genoeg. Jy maak my seer. Ek moes die man kleiner gekies het. God wants to rid us of sin. We have to. How do we lay off? Yes, Lord, it is sin. 1 John 1 verse 9. If we confess, he is faithful and just to forgive us. To forgive us. Sorry, I'm wearing this tie. Forgiveness. And to restore us. To take it off. God removes. We just have to let him. Lay off the old. The problem is, too many people in the church declare themselves to be new, but they look, the new still looks like the old. The old hasn't gone. It's all just, but listen, Jesus died, not just to save you, but to shape you. Jesus died to set you free from sin. Well, yeah, yeah. As die dominee sê, ons kan ontsla raak van so, oh ja, as ons dood gaan. Nee. As ons met dood gaan, dan is dit die dood wat jou red, nie Jesus nie. As jy eers sondeloos is met die dood, dan red die dood jou. Hoor jy my volgende? Jesus. But we have to agree. We have to know what sin is. We have to know what, and listen to me, each one of us has a different sin to the other. I'm okay with drinking because I've changed fountains, so I'm not tempted by that other fountain anymore. I still drink, I just drink from a different fountain. So I don't have a problem with alcohol and with any of that kind of stuff, but you might. I may have a problem with greed or with money or with whatever. I need to know because the Holy Spirit will point it out to me. The truth will have been taught to me. And the truth will set you free. You'll know where you can get close to sin. But what do? We point out all the sins that we don't have a problem with. And your drinking becomes my biggest bone of contention. You say you're a Christian, but you drink still. Just don't talk about greed, okay? Because then... Everyone says, but we need to lay off the old so that we can put on the new. I'm going to talk just now about the practical side of that. But Marlies is going to come here and she wants to give you a blessing. Ja. Ek wil haar iets gee om vir julle te gee. Kry beheer asseblief. Kry net bietjie beheer. Help haar bietjie daar asseblief. Hierdie is nie ingeoefen. Okay, Marlies, ek wil hê jy moet hierdie met die gemeente deel asseblief. Hoekom nie? Wat is fout mee? Kom, ek maak het oor. Rarig. You see how you need to lay off the old in order to pick up the new. If you haven't laid off the old, Nee, moet nie gooi. Sy kan in elk geval, al was daar niks in haar hande nie. Toe maar. Jy mag gaan sit, dankie. If we're not prepared to lay off the old, we don't have space to take on any of the new. You can. Jy sal start. Nie in jouself, in die waarheid van wie Jesus Christus is en die werk wat hy op die kruis gedoen het. You must know what you know. Because faith, listen to me, faith trumps life. Mense loop so rond, dan sê hulle, ek kan nie, ek weet jy kan nie. Want die Here het klaar vir jou gesê, 2 jaar terug, lê daai neer, maar jy dra hom nog steeds, jy hou hom nog steeds vas. En nou vandag is die geleentheid om met oorwinning op te staan, maar jy kan nie, want jy is vasgevang met die sonde, wat jy moes al afgelê het. God het jou al gewys, dis 'n probleem in jou lewe. Ja, maar dis 'n algemene probleem, almal het dit. Maar ek wil met jou werk. I'm intimately involved in your life. I'm not interested that everybody has sin. I'm dealing with this sin in your life. Listen to me, child of mine. Oeg, julle oumas en oupas. Julle het die soetste, slimste kleinkinders in die wêreld. Is dit nie so nie? Ja, verseker. Ja, en elkeen van julle sin. Maar praat bietjie met die ouers. Oeg, hulle dryf my teen die mure uit. Ag nee man, gee hom net 'n chocolate. Bring hom net, ja, it's problem parents, it's not problem grandkids. Hoeveel van julle het al na jou ma en pa gekyk en wie's jy? Want hulle laat toe wat jy sou al in blood nose, hulle het jou so hard hier geslaan, jou neus het gebloei. Toe jy daai gedoen het, toe jy kind was, maar nou is ouma en oupa daar. Ag, shame, dis niks man, hy's net kind. Toe ek kind was, wou jy my doodmaak, maar hy's net kind. Now to teenagers. Run to your grandparents. God says, faith trumps life. Don't hold on to the futility of your mind. Don't hold on to your lack of understanding of the life that God has for you in Christ Jesus. Let go. And let God, when He points something out to you, don't justify it. Confess it. Moet dit nie regverdig, moet dit nie verdedig. Sê, ek het gesondig, ja, dit is sonde. Jammer. Let go, that God can fill you. Therefore, verse 25, therefore, laying aside falsehood, speak truth, each one of you with his neighbor, for we are members of one another. Daar sê, be loving, don't be nice, speak the truth. Does this dress make me look fat? No, it's the chocolates you eat that make you look fat. Don't blame the dress. Speak the truth. We're members of one body. We're members of one another. Be angry and yet do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Why does he suddenly, he says, speak the truth, do not be angry. When you don't speak the truth, what happens? You become frustrated because you can't be real. And you eventually get angry. So speak the truth. Or else what's going to happen? In you, anger is going to take root. Speak the truth. Be yourself. Now, with respect. Met respect. Met liefde. Praat die waarheid met liefde. So neem in ag die ander persoon. Jy breek hulle nie af nie. Inteendeel, ons gaan nou daar uitkom. But don't lie. Don't cover up. If someone's doing something that irritates the poo out of you, let them know. Or else you're going to walk around smelling. You're going to become angry. You're going to become filled with stuff that you don't want to be filled with. Love and with respect. Do not let the anger. Be angry and yet do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. And do not give the devil an opportunity. He loves it. When you withhold truth, you speak a white lie. God sê nie kleur en leuns nie, hoor. Daar is nie 'n wit en 'n swart leuen nie. There's no white lie. It's right or wrong. Don't give the devil an opportunity. He loves it when you start becoming like the father of lies. He who steals must steal no longer. When do you start stealing? When you feel that you need it and it's been withheld from you, or you can't afford it because God hasn't enabled you. And so out of me being myself, the same as lying comes stealing. It's a progression. Sonde lei tot sonde. He who steals must steal no longer, but rather he must work, performing with his own hands what is good, so that he will have something to share with one who has need. Share something with someone who has need. Now we immediately think, okay, stealing, physically stealing, and working physically so that we can. But look at the next verse. Let no unwholesome word proceed from your mouth, but only such a word as is good for edification according to the need of the moment, so that it will be grace to those who need it. Don't steal grace from other people. Moenie genade steal van ander mense af nie. Maar as jy te min het, as jy 'n minderheidskompleks het, dan sal jy steel en jy sal niks hê om weg te gee. Maar as jy genoeg genade, as jy genoeg van God het, as jy die ou afgelê het en die nuwe aangetrek het, as jy besig is om te floreer en die genade van God, die liefde van God, die barmhartigheid, die insig, die wysheid, die alles van God wat hy vir jou voorberei het in die hemele, in Jesus Christus, as jy daai het, dan het jy baie meer, maar jy moet daaraan werk. Because you must lay off and you must put on. Too many Christians sit in church and steal other people's testimonies, the pastor's testimony, the pastor's teaching. Jy het nie self ontdek, want jy kom nooit self in die woord nie. God kan jou nooit 'n woord van getuienis vir jouself gee, want jy is te besig om ander mense se geloof te steel en dit te probeer uitleef, want jy wil nie daaraan self werk nie. Want jy het niks om te gee. Enna. Never thought of that, eh? Ask God this week. Give me something out of your word to share with someone else. Not what I've heard from someone else. Give me something that I can share with someone else. You know what's so awesome? Let no unwholesome word come out of your mouth, but only a word that's beneficial for edification. Every single life is a building site. Every single person is a building site. And God's still working on you. How do I know? You're still breathing. When he's finished with you, you won't be breathing anymore. Okay. So while he's busy building on you, and I come onto your building site, may I not steal your bricks to put in my house. May I leave building material there that you can continue to build with. That's a nice picture, eh? that when you look around, after I've been in your presence, you've got something positive to work into your life. Because I've been there. Come on, church. That's what we're here for. That's what we're here for. Can I underline that for you? Can I show you how serious this is? Do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. What does that mean? Do not grieve the Holy Spirit in the context of let no unwholesome word come out your mouth. So God's busy working on these building sites. He's busy working on Luray, and he's busy affirming, and he's saying, Luray, you're entering a new phase and it's going well with you, and you're finding yourself and emotionally you're coming right, and I'm giving you the tools and I'm giving you the equipment and everything that you need to build yourself. And then Sean comes along, he says, hey, Luray, why are you still acting like a two-year-old? When are you going to grow up, man? Every time I see you, you're going a tantrum. And the Holy Spirit goes, what did you just say, you idiot? I'm busy building, and you come, and you've just broken everything down that I'm busy doing in Lorraine's life. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit. God, when you walk away from a conversation, God shouldn't say, I wish I'd shut his mouth. Ek moes sy bek toegeklap het. I can't believe he just said that about that person. It's taken me 5 years to get that person over, and in one sentence, we got to start 5 years back. Let no unwholesome word proceed out of your mouth. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit. Be in tune with the Holy Spirit as you deal with one another. That's laying off the old and putting on the new. Jonge, myself so hard geklap, ek het nou sommer 'n kop seer. Shoo. Suffering for the gospel. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God by whom you are sealed for the day of redemption. Do you know? Do you know? Let's go back to the truth. Let's go back to the truth. Too many people in the church still look like the old instead of the new. What happened at salvation? You didn't pray a prayer. You didn't sign a tract. You didn't join a church. You didn't start giving financially. You didn't start. What happened at salvation is you were reborn. You were born again. Jy's wedergebore. You got a new life. You were sealed and filled with the Holy Spirit of God. Dis 'n verandering wat daar plaasgevind het. Jy's nie meer, you're no longer in the futility of your own mind. You're now led by the wisdom and insight and truth of the Holy Spirit that leads you into all truth, reveals the Father to you. You live differently. You've got a different worldview. You've got a different perspective. Die ou ding van, if it walks like a duck and quacks like a duck, then it is a... not a gosling. A duck. Unfortunately, we walk and talk and look like the futility of our mind, that we lack understanding of the life that God has given us. We don't live to the extreme. We don't. You know what? Don't invite people to church. Invite people to your new life in Christ Jesus. That's a true witness. Jeez, I used to know you. You've changed. What the heck has happened? Jesus has happened. I can't ascribe it to anything else but Jesus. Dis die verandering wat in my plaas gevind het. And then, Marlies, ek wil tel weer jou balletjies op en kom weer. Jy het gedink jy is af. Jy werk oortyd vandag. Ja, nee, los hy en ons gaan sukkel. Klein handjies. Ephesians 4:31-32, I'm finishing. Marlies, let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and slander be put away from you. Let all the malice go. God wants, God wants to deal. God wants to deal. God wants to deal. God wants to deal with your yesterday. God wil met jou gister deal. Soveel mense kom na my toe. En dan is hulle stikkend vandag. Hulle is vandag stikkend. Maar as ons begin, the onion, we start peeling the layers of the onion. Then it was yesterday. And so and so. And that person. And this person. And in my father's house. And my mother. And my brothers. And my sisters. And my this. And my teacher. And my friends. And my... And it's built up from so far back. And we're holding on to bitterness and to wrath and to slander and to clamor, the noise. Die geraas van gister is so vol in ons. Ons kan nie God se stem vandag hoor nie. And I said to you last week, it's an easy message, but it's a hard emotional message for a pastor to preach this because I deal with the hurt of hurting people every day. And I wish I could tell you how frustrated I get because I know that I know that I know that I know that it's Jesus, and they in their heads are saying Jesus, but in their hearts they're still holding on to revenge and to payback and to hulle kry lekker as daai ou seer kry. Dis hoekom my vieslike TikTok scrap op social media is van hy ou wat gedood is, hoe hy geslaan is by 'n watergat. And it's eye of the tiger and groblis val or groblis dal. Sick, man. People who post it are saying more about themselves than what they're saying about the guy who gets his face hit off him. And it's posted as, oh, this is lekker. En net daarna is hy doodgery. Maar hulle post nog steeds. Gaan nie oor hom nie, gaan oor die siekte. Die bitterheid, die lekker kry, die what did Malie say at the beginning? When you get bumped, what comes out of you? Anger, bitterness. We can, oh, jonne, Christians, ons sit ons glimlagtanne in ons, kry ons hare reg, sit die das aan, ons trek mooi aan, en ons kom vroom kerk toe, I'm blessed by the best. But let someone bump you. What comes out? Dis die toets. Let go of it. Let go. Marlies, kom help my. Ek kan nie buk nie. Pas op vir jou oë. Gooi, tannie, gooi. Die mense daar agter. Okay, vir almal wat nou 'n sweetie gevang het, hoekom het jy nie 'n Bybel in jou hand nie? Nee, toe maar los dit dan. Ooh, I couldn't resist. What areas of sin? Compromise. And justification are you living with? I've said enough. Let the Holy Spirit now speak. Come on, but Father, you're the one who loves us and knows us. Holy Spirit, I can't do any more justice to the truth of Ephesians 5:17 to 32. You have to now speak to each heart. Holy Spirit, take this poor effort of trying to inspire people out of the word and speak directly to each heart. You know what each person needs to hear. You know what each person needs. I threw chocolates out. Melise threw chocolates out. You wanna remove the futility of our minds where we settle for something that's not the life of God for us. You want us to lay off and we're holding on. You want to give us so that we can be a blessing to others, and we want to hold on to bitterness and anger and wrath and clamor and slander and malice. We don't want to be kind to one another. We don't want to be tender-hearted, forgiving each other, just as God in Christ also has forgiven us. Help us, Holy Spirit. Help ons, Heilige Gees. Mag elkeen wat hier is vanoggend, en ons is hier met 'n rede. Ons is hier omdat U bestem het ons moet hier wees vandag. Help ons om ons hande oop te maak, los aan daai van gister, sodat ons U seën vir vandag en môre kan ontvang. Heilige Gees, kom wys uit daar waar ons sondes regverdig en ons hou vas aan hulle. U seën het gesterf dat ons daai vashou van daai sonde en ons kan gebreek word. Daai sonde kan uit ons lewe verwyder word. Help us, Lord. Come, Holy Spirit. Deal with me. Deal with us. I pray for those who have never truly accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. You've maybe prayed a prayer, but your life hasn't been radically altered. There's no old that you can refer back to. There's no new that you can testify about. I pray that in your heart you will now ask Jesus to come and to set you free, to be your Lord, to be your Savior. Maybe you have been saved, but you've gone off the path. You've just drifted in the noise of this world and the busyness of life. You know that you're not in the Word. You're not the first love, the passion, the desire, the joy, the want to is gone, and you're just doing Christianity as a work, something to suffer through. You're keeping up an image because that's what you've declared yourself. I pray that God will stir your heart through the Holy Spirit. Dat hy jou weer sal warm maak. Dat jy nie lou warm sal wees, maar dat jy weer warm sal wees in die Here. Dis net die Heilige Gees wat daai werk kan doen. Ek bid vir elkeen wat in 'n nuwe seisoen, in 'n nuwe routine moet ingaan. En hulle moet hulle self vind in hierdie nuwe indeling, hierdie nuwe fase van hulle lewens. Ek bid dat U Heilige Gees hulle sal die rigting en die waarheid en die insig en die kennis gee. That they won't live in the futility and lack of understanding, but that they'll live the life, the truth that they've been taught and that they've heard in Jesus Christ. That every day will be Jesus. And I pray that the kingdom of God, every church in this valley that proclaims the word of God, that those who hear the word will live the word. Jesus Christ was the word, became flesh, so that we who are flesh can become word. We can live this truth to your glory. Help us to do that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Here in the love of Christ, I stand. Again.